Assalamualaikum. This is the equipment from the Soltech free enforced convection heat exchanger model 106. On this equipment we can perform two experiments. The first one is about the free enforced convection. Okay, what is the effect of increasing the speed of air on a surface, and the other one is the effect of increasing the area of the surface, or simply the difference between a flat plate and the fin plate. Here you can see some controls on the right hand. The first one is the heater power. The second one, heater control. The bottom one, knob black. The third one is a temperature indicator display. That's red one is a temperature selector switch, and the bottom one is air velocity. From this knob we can control the fan speed or the air speed, and on the right hand side there is a red switch of heater switch, and this yellow one is basically the main switch. Okay, these are basically the parameters. We can change them. Okay, now you can see that I can increase or decrease the power of heater using this knob. Okay, I can suppose set it at 40, and T1 is 19, T3 is 19 approximately, because the experiments have just started yet, so all these temperatures are basically close to each other, close to the atmosphere. Okay, now we can look at the different parts of it. The left one, on the left one you can see the test section, this vertical tube right at the left, that's basically our test section. There are two fans on the top of it. There is an anemometer at the bottom, the green one. This is here to basically measure the speed of air in the test section. And here behind the acrylic you can see the test surface. Okay, there are three temperature indicators, or three thermistors, T1, T2 and T3, indicating the temperature at the different positions of the surface or the fin surface. That's a heater plug. So T1, T2 and T3 are the temperatures along the fin surface. T4 is the ambient temperature, or the TA, that's the T4. And T5 is the heater surface temperature, the temperature of the bottom surface of the fins. Like, okay, you can see the other fins here. This is also a fin surface, cylindrical ones. So this is the plug for heater, and right here we can actually insert the plug to measure the temperature of the surface. So T5 is basically the temperature of this surface. The one mounted there are basically the rectangular, thin rectangular section. This one is similar. I have another section of flat plate I can use any of these in different combinations in different experiments. Okay, so first of all, what I have to do, if we look at it, the first experiment, in the first experiment, we have to determine the relationship between the power input and the surface temperature. And using that, I have to study the free and forced convection. Okay. Basically, in the first experiment, what we have to do, I'll choose any of the surface, whether I choose a thin one or a flat one, up to me or up to the student. So, for example, if I have done in the first experiment, what I have to do, I have to study the effect of free and forced convection on this surface. So, what is the effect of if I increase the speed of air on this surface, and in the case when there is no air or when there is like no flow of air in the test section, so that would be a case of free convection. I'll use different power inputs for the heater. Using that, I'll check the temperature of the surface. Like, what is the temperature of the surface at different power inputs? So that is, I'll check the value of TH for TH is the temperature of the bottom of the tested surface, and the TA, I'll check these two temperatures that are of my concern. So using that, I can do that experiment. Like, first of all, I'll set it at, for example, 20. I'll check the temperature of this one in the case of free convection when there is no heat, when there is no motion of the air in the test section. So I'll increase it to 30, and then I'll again check the temperature 40, and then I'll again check the temperature. So using that, I'll get the temperature of the tested surface, the bottom of the tested surface at different power inputs. So that will give me a one value. So I basically want to compare this value with the first one. So I'll induce the motion of air in the test section at different speed. I can use that. move these fans actually at different speed. So I have right here, it's 0.5. So it's a slow speed. So first of all, the first reading will be taken at zero air velocity. Like, I'll set it at zero and check three to four readings at zero velocity that would go into the free convection. And for the forced convection readings, I'll set it at 0.5. First reading can be taken at 0.5. Okay, just a bit. The second reading I can take at 1 meter per second, and then 1.5, and then 2 meter per second. So using that, I can note the four readings at different velocity input that can be for forced convection. So comparing these two values, I can check what is the effect of free and forced convection. This is the part one of the apparatus of the text. The other experiment, I have to basically check the effect of increasing the heat transfer area. So what is the effect of rate of heat transfer if I increase the area? So so for that, I'll have to use one flat plate and one thin plate. Okay, so I can do it in both cases, but I'll set for that, I'll make a fixed speed of air, or I can use it in perform this experiment in free convection mode and the forced convection mode, but I'll recommend the forced convection mode. I'll set the speed to 1 meter per second for the second part. Now, okay, I'll set the speed at 1 meter per second. So what I'll do then, okay, I'll perform the same experiment, but I have to check the effect of the surface, the effect of increasing surface area. So basically, करना क्या है कि पहले मैं flat plate use करूँगा, और इस पर एक फिक्स स्पीड पे आई नॉट चेंज द फ्री एंड फोर्स कन्वेक्शन इज नॉट माई फोकस सो आई कीप द स्पीड ऑफ द एयर फिक्स. तो एयर की स्पीड को कॉन्स्टेंट रखना है, उसको चेंज नहीं करना वट एवर इट इज़. उसके बाद तीन से चार रीडिंग इस पर डिफरेंट पावर इनपुट्स पे और इसका सरफेस टेम्परेचर चेक करना है, और उसके बाद तीन से चार रीडिंग डिफरेंट पावर इनपुट्स पे इसके लिए. तो आई फॉर द सेम पावर इनपुट यानी आई विल कंपेयर कि जब 20 वाट पावर थी तब इसका क्या टेम्परेचर था और 20 वाट पावर पे फिन का क्या टेम्परेचर है, और फिर 30 वाट पावर पे फ्लैट का क्या टेम्परेचर है और 40 वाट पावर पे फिन का क्या टेम्परेचर है. तो वी कैन सी दैट कि जो सेम पावर इनपुट पे जो फिन का टेम्परेचर होगा वो क्या होगा, एक्चुअली कम होगा. क्यों? क्योंकि वहाँ पे रेट ऑफ हीट ट्रांसफ़र ज़्यादा है, तो इसलिए जो बेस प्लेट है उसका टेम्परेचर क्या होगा, कम होगा. और 30 इसी तरह आई विल कंपेयर 30 पे जब दोनों की वैल्यूज को कंपेयर करूँगा फ्लैट और फिन्स की, तब भी क्या होगा कि आई विल नोट कि फिन का टेम्परेचर क्या है कम है और फ्लैट का टेम्परेचर क्या है ज़्यादा है. तो ये वैल्यूज़ क्या करेंगी, बेसिकली इंडिकेट करेंगी कि सरफेस एरिया बढ़ाने से क्या होता है, एक्चुअली रेट ऑफ हीट ट्रांसफ़र इंक्रीज़ हो जाता है. इसलिए फिन सरफेस में फ्लैट बॉटम प्लेट का टेम्परेचर कम होगा और इसका टेम्परेचर क्या होगा, ज़्यादा होगा. दिस इज़ द सेकेंड एक्सपेरिमेंट. पहले एक्सपेरिमेंट में क्या चेक करना था, सिर्फ फ्री और फोर्स का इफेक्ट चेक करना था. उसमें बेसिकली आपने क्या करना है, रिपीट कि आपने एक प्लेट लेनी है, जो मर्जी ले लें, चाहे फ्लैट ले लें चाहे फिन ले लें. इफ़ आई यूज़ फिन तो एक्सपेरिमेंट जल्दी हो जाएगा जस्ट. तो इस पर आपने क्या करना है, फ्री एंड फोर्स कन्वेक्शन का इफेक्ट चेक करना है. तीन से चार रीडिंग लें आप डिफरेंट पावर इनपुट्स पे, ठीक है, फ्री के केस में, मतलब कोई एयर मोशन नहीं है. 20, 30 और 40 वाट पे रीडिंग ली और फिर उसके बाद फोर्स पे रीडिंग ली और दोनों का क्या कर लिया, कंपेयर कर लिया. This is the way we have to perform this experiment. Two experiments can be performed this way. We can go for the other ones, but these are two basic experiments that we use to perform on this equipment. Okay, any question you can ask. Thank you. This is about the basic salting model HE106 free and forced convection heat exchanger. Okay, moreover, one thing I want to tell, the fans are not like pushing air to the downward, they are basically creating a vacuum at the upper section, so they are just sucking the air in upward direction. So actually, jo air ki direction hai wo upward direction mein, kyunki induced convection jo hai fans produce karte hain in that case.